when I start the separator, this motor is going to start. Right? When this motor will start,
the following video is a part of the Achievers package. In case you find the video helpful and want to watch more such videos like Purifier System Layout, Purifier, Factors for Purification, Purifier and Clarifier Difference, Purifier Role of Gravity Disk, Purifier Automation, Purifier ALCAP Explanation, etc. Find the link of the Achievers package in the description box below.
Hi guys, Jai Mata Di. Today I am going to start a dual purifier in front of you. So guys, this is my purifier. This is alpha level clarifier and purifier that is. This is a motor. When this motor starts turning with the belt inside, it starts rotating this purifier over here. These are the solenoid valve filters for displacement water, opening water, closing water. This is the airline. I am opening this airline valve, so I can see the pressure over here. These airline valves are for operating various valves over here which are air operated. Perfect guys, then I am operating. This is the water valve. When I open this valve, now this water is waiting over here. When this solenoid valve gets activated as per the timer, the water is going either to the opening water, closing water or displacement water over here. Right guys? So now, this is my purifier feed pump over here guys. First thing is I will start the purifier feed pump and this oil will go through the heater and circulate from settling tank to settling tank, from settling to settling tank, so that the temperature comes up. Come. Before starting the purifier guys, I have to see, there is an interlock over here. This is the sludge port, so I have to open this valve. If I do not open this valve, then the purifier will not start. It's an interlock. Come guys. So now I will start the feed pump. Feed pump started. Okay guys, the feed pump has started. You can see the indication over here. And now I want to see the temperature. Now slowly I will open the valve. Okay, now slowly I am going to open the steam valve and you will see it is going through the heater, the steam and the oil is being circulated, so the temperature over here is starting to increase. Now it is 77 degrees. Now initially when we start this, we are putting with the bypass valve, but over here we have got an auto heater over here. So later on I will put it in auto. This heater is going to take over the control and regulate the temperature of the, regulate the fuel oil inlet temperature, which we want to maintain at the purifier. Okay guys, come. So let it circulate for some time. I can see the temperature over here. I can start the purifier now. For starting the purifier, first I will start the separator. When I start the separator, this motor is going to start. Right? When this motor will start, then you can see the amperage coming up over here. For starting the separator, I will press this button and start the separator. As soon as I start the separator, you will see the motor will start. Okay guys? Now the first question asks is, has the valve been dismantled? Plus is yes, minus is no. Now guys, in ALCAP purifier, if you put in the, you have dismantled the valve, cleaned the valve, then definitely in that case, you will have to write plus. That means yes. Why? Then a complete calibration procedure happens over here inside. Otherwise, you will put minus, no. Then say, start. So now I press the separator button once again. Right? Now I have to start the separator, so I press this button. That the motor amperage is right now too much. Why? Because right now the motor has to achieve 40 rpm, but the valve is, it has to start. So a lot of load is coming on the motor to maintain that load. But you can see the rpm is increasing slowly, slowly, right? And as soon as the rpm reaches, you will see this amperage. The your motor amperage will start decreasing. Right guys? So our basic aim is to ensure that the motor amperage has come to the rated amp. See, right now it is 6100. Increasing. The amperage is around 16.5. Okay, 7100. 7200. 7300. 600. Now, how is this motor rotating? Guys, motor is rotating with the motor, with the belt. This car is kind of rotating, right? Now, what is RPM comes to around 8000? And oh, now see, guys, the RPM has reduced. The RPM has reduced, guys. Now, why this RPM has reduced? Because 9000 RPM has come over here. How this 9000 RPM has come? Because of this motor. Okay, so now the amperage is good, everything is good. So now we are ready to start the kickstart, guys. Let me see the temperature. For starting the purifier has started, right? Now guys, in this system the purifier has automatically started. You can see this solenoid got 16. Can you see this rotating over here? This is the solenoid valve. Okay, now the other solenoid valve is rotating. Okay guys, this SV10, SV15, SV16 have got their own importance. One is for displacement water or sealing water. One is for opening the bowl. One is for closing the bowl. That is how it works. Yes, sir. Guys, there are a lot of parameters you have to look into over here. See, so many things to look at. These are the timers going on. Now guys, if you really want to understand the timers, you have to read the manual and just understand how this automation works, which is very, very important. Now this PA valve is actually into the... Now slowly have to increase the temperature, guys. I have to bring the temperature to around 90 degrees, guys. As per the requirement. So now the field inlet is going into the purifier. This PT4 is the discharge pressure gauge, discharge pressure transmitter. Right, guys? Now, guys, this is my three-way valve, guys. This is my three-way valve operated by air. So this is the one which is responsible for sending the oil either into the purifier or bypassing the purifier and sending back into the settling tank. Got it, guys? Once the oil goes into the purifier, then it goes into the service tank. Now, this is PT4 is my back pressure. PT5 is the water pressure, guys. Guys, this is the water circulated over here. This senses how much is the water quantity in the oil. There is a single revolution. Guys, there is a lot of automation, how this works, what all the points are. But the basic layout is, this is how a purifier is run. Now, say this purifier is running, I have to deselect the purifier. Now, when I deselect the purifier, what happens is, first of all, displacement water will go in, it will displace the oil. So this solenoid will get activated. Before that, this feed will stop. This will stop. The oil will circulate back to the settling tank. Displacement water will go, and then opening water will go and open the valve. So let's do the Okay, guys, this is the 68. TI 68 is the time of desludge. So we have the desludging period at 90 minutes. So now already 1 minute has gone. So when I press the desludging period, what will happen is, you will see this light will go, this three valve will get activated, and now no more oil is getting into the purifier, and then this valve will get activated first. Let us see what happens. See, so now no more oil going into the purifier. Stop it. Oil is going for the displacement. You can see water is going for displacement. Water is going displacing the oil. Okay, this burner ball is on, you can see over here. Now once this light goes, you will see there will be a pump. You will hear a loud thud noise. This thing will happen and you will see a very big thing over here. Just press that. Just it. The timer here and over here for adding the duplication button is now 20 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Can you see the amperage coming up and now coming down? This was the opening water which went in. Copy guys? It was just for a time period of just 3 seconds guys. Just for a time period of 3 seconds. So this has just happened. Now again, what is this? This is the closing water going in. Can you see this? This is your closing water going in. So closing the valve. Once the valve closes, everything stabilizes. Again the feed will start and the pressure will get stabilized. Let us see what happens. Now, okay, guys, speed has started. Can you see that? The oil is going into the filter right now. Everything is stabilized. The pressure is around 88. Inlet speed, guys, always understand that the minimum speed rate should be there with the filter. In our case, we can maintain around 1.5 to 1.6 mm. Now, once the temperature stabilizes and puts the filter inside the bypass one, then this filter valve will automatically open, close, and maintain the fuel outlet temperature. If in case I have to stop the filter, I will just press the stop button and then this filter will reset and then stop. That's it, what you have to know. A simple way of explaining how a purifier is starting, how a disturbing is taking place over there. A lot needs to be explained in story that I'll do later on. Thank you very much. Jai Mata.
If you found the video helpful, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. To watch more such technical videos, check out this playlist on the screen and find the link of the Achievers package in the description box below. Thank you.